Use eggs, we're going to use 2 yolks of an egg. I'll tell you what we're going to put in here. So, in this is something I invented. There is no grass emulsion for oil paint. That means usually mixed with the water and a pigment and then painted with, which is very tedious. It works great. Antigone did that, but it's a lot of work. So this emulsion is kind of an innovation. It's similar to Antigone's. Do y'all know Antigone's work? Uh-huh. Yeah, you'll see it in the slideshow. He's one of the 2 master painters that Fuchs went to go meet. He never told anybody. Yeah. He's a brilliant Florentine painter. He died in the late 80s. So we're going to use 1 part cold pressed linseed oil. You're going to all get this, but if you want to write it down, you can. 1/2 of 1 part Venice turpentine, 1/2 of 1 part stand oil, 1/2 of 1 part Dalmar varnish, and then a few drops of Sikkativ. I'm going to talk about that a little bit. So I don't care who else you studied with and told you to use some dryers other than this nice clear liquid, which is a Sikkativ. That's something that dries medium and oils faster. And you have to be very careful and specific with it, because if you use too much, your painting will crack completely and blister and act really funky. The worst dryer is cobalt linoleate. It's purple and it does terrible things. Never use that. And then there's the second terrible, the Sikkativ de Haarlem. That's also not nearly as good. It darkens easy, it also cracks paint, unless you know how to really use it well. And why use it when you can get something as fine as the Lefranc Bourgeois one? So that's what you would want to use if you want to use dryers.
You don't have to.
You can pass it around. Okay, the best thing to use is organic eggs, because they're just more pure. And it's best to have them at room temperature, because it's just easy to deal with. But these are still pretty cold, but we have an expert Yolkinian separator. So we're okay with that. Where's the bottle I'm going to use? Okay, so a bowl to catch the white egg. All right, Rebecca, you're on.
Okay. But you don't have to use it specifically, right?
We will use to make a few drops of it. Yeah, at the end. So you want to keep 1 eggshell. We want to tap the hole in it because we want to preserve 1 of the eggshells. We're going to use it to measure the other things.
Okay, so you want
to we get an exact measurement then.
Okay.
Yeah. The other egg doesn't matter.
They're quite hard shells, actually.
Aren't they? Yeah. You want me to try and do it? Oh, you do it like that?
Yeah, just slice the top.
Okay.
And then there you are. It's most of it.
All right, you can, yeah.
You don't want the yolk broken, you want the yolk integral.
Well, yeah, I mean, eventually it's going to be broken. And we don't want the skin to go into the bottom. That's the thing.
That's a funny version, I've said before.
Yeah, you can use the bowl. Sure.
I think it's broken.
Try and save me out. Yeah, but we don't want the skin. That's
I've
okay.
got the skin. I'm holding the skin. I'm holding it where it is.
None of the skin with it?
No, look, it's here.
All right.
What happens if the skin goes on?
It will degrade faster, and the binding qualities are affected. Because the skin really isn't yolk, it's something else. It's the sac that holds the yolk. Mm-hmm. All right, the other one, yeah. Yeah, we want to save that one. You think it's easier when it's room temperature, the shell? Yeah. Yeah, so it's good to keep it at room temperature. But we don't want to wait all day for them to warm up.
Can you only use chicken eggs?
Huh?
Can you only use chicken eggs?
Chicken eggs?
Yeah.
Well, I've always wanted to try an ostrich.
Yeah.
You know, what
about a duck? Yeah,
I don't know. I don't know of any artists historically that have tried various eggs. It's an interesting question. And are all yolks the same chemically?
Yeah.
I really don't know.
I think duck eggs are a little fattier.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
I would think. The more wild the bird, I would think it's fattier. Yeah? So I don't know. Maybe you discover a better yolk.
Yeah.
Emily's been progressing.
All right, so both are in there?
Nice.
Two yolks?
Just one. Okay. Oh. Do you want the other egg like this, or does it
matter? No. As long as we have one
okay.
container.
So I can
right?
just break this the normal way.
Oh, you're a little bit warm.
And do you want the white? You don't want the white.
You don't want the white or the shell?
Or the
stuff connected to the yolk, you know, that sometimes is stringy.
Yeah, there it is. Okay, so you want to
Yeah, so you do it quite differently. I do it, I dry out the sack first.
Oh, no, I don't bother.
So I can dangle it.
I was taught to do that, but I just don't do it anymore.
Okay, you got your own yolk
technique.
No,
you're right. You
should see when they.
So that other way, you should show everybody how to do the other way too, right? So people know how to do that. Because that's really weird. Even if you work with eggs, that thing where you use the paper towel,
pass it back
and forth, and dry it. And
yeah, traditionally the yolk is dried out.
It's kind of
easy. By passing it back and forth in your hands, wiping your hand off, back and forth, till you can hold the sack and it doesn't break. And then you would just hold it over it and pierce it. But the way she did it's fine. I don't think we got any.
Huh? I think I've just got lazy every time.
As long as it's only.
When do you use yolk without the membrane?
I took the membrane in my hand.
I know, but when would you use that? Like, I would never have done that in cooking. Like, why would you ever do that other than this? So how do you know how to do it?
Oh, no, I didn't know you took it out in cooking. I've never taken away the membrane when I was cooking.
Oh, okay. You looked very experienced at it. So
I make tempera.
For painting.
Oh, okay. Yes. Okay, so you've made the tempera before.
Yes.
Okay, got it.
Yeah, so you painted in puree tempera.
Pure egg.
So she would use only the yolk. Well, that's good you got that experience. All right, so then.
It's much faster.
What I do is put the heavier other substances first so that the thinner ones kind of wash out the funnel. So, stand oil is going to be the heaviest thing. Okay. So, who wants to volunteer and be an alpha?
I
want
to.
Okay. I get the feeling that.
All right, we want to retain this. That's our measuring cup.
Okay.
This is good enough. So, we want to put half of an eggshell.
Oh.
Yeah, yeah, feel free to eat it. I'm used to it with the newspapers.
Oh, yes,
oh, yeah, it's been a year. Oi!
Is there another name for stand oil? What is stand oil?
There is one other term for it.
Stand oil?
Sun-dried oil. Mm-hmm. It's a little different. I mean, it's basically the same, really. You could say. It's a different process. But sun-dried oil would be the same thing. It's as thick as honey.
Okay.
And we're going to use Venice turpentine, which is, should also be as thick as honey, but the one we got is thinner. It won't hurt anything, but it's just not.
So half of the egg.
Half of an eggshell. You're all going to get a handout when I get it copied. Good? All right, just turn it upside down until we get, it'll take a while to go in there.
Why do you use the funnel again? What did you say?
Well, I mean, it's just easier to get everything in there without spilling it everywhere, yeah?
And
then shake it. In the end, we shake it. Alright, so next heaviest thing would be the Venice turpentine. And this is not a good one. It's not bad, but it's kind of thin for Venice turpentine, which isn't really turpentine.
Mm.
It's actually more of a resin.
Oh.
Why they call it that? I have no idea. But I love how it smells.
What's it made from?
It's a balsam, like pine tree saps and... Yeah, it's a tree sap, basically.
Okay.
Oh. Maybe only a trees found in Venice. I guess.
Yeah, es ist wie ein Malmedium, ein Ödel. Die nennen es einfach nur Venice Turpentine, aber es ist kein Turpentine.
Was ist es dann?
A resin. Mehr weiß ich leider nicht. Also irgendein Harz. Eigentlich hat er gesagt, der Harz.
A Harz?
Alright, we need an
eyedropper.
Aber vielleicht fragen wir ihn einfach nochmal. Ich habe es früher schon gelesen, aber ich bin nicht drauf gekommen, was es genau ist.
It's just because
I press it like from a tree.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
But this actually I got that in England.
Very
cool. Probably why it sucked. But Old Holland would probably be much better. Talons, yeah. Of course it's better companies. So. Or yeah. Lucas. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so now half of one part varnish. Now there's 100 ways to make emulsions. And you experiment with it and see why one is different than another. Yeah?
Some of them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, half an egg. Now this one is actually different than last summer that I was using. So it's kind of tweaked another degree.
So was that a half, the Venice turpentine, or was it a one, a whole?
It's all half parts.
Whole
except half. For, we didn't do cold press linseed oil yet, did
no.
we? All right, so yeah. That'll be the last one. That's a whole part.
It's a little hot.
So. Okay. Cold pressed lentil.
So, what if we use your old recipe?
It still works. This works better.
New and improved.
I think it will. I mean, it did in Tucson. Maybe it'll be different here. Tucson's 120 degrees.
Yeah.
But I don't see any reason why it wouldn't work as well.
Oh, it's the cold one.
Also, a half egg.
No, a whole.
A whole one?
Yeah.
Linseed oil.
But the cold one.
Is this what I passed around and told you was a dryer? Yeah. I hope not.
Uh-huh.
Is that
no.
Free retail?
Oh, yeah.
No one said anything?
Get your hand on it.
Wait a minute.
Before I some bone landed.
Yeah, you passed that around.
So where is the retail? Where is the... Yeah, this is fantastic. Didn't we look at the secretive earlier today? What did we do with it?
Nothing.
No, I mean...
It's still there, isn't it?
Huh?
It's still there.
Yeah, but where? I don't see it. Oh, here it is. Okay. Yeah, it's Collins. It's not LeFranc Bourgeois. So we must have been looking at the retouch furnace like retouch.
I thought you meant it was a secretive.
Where's this from?
How did
yeast
it?
Huh? What do you need?
What is this? Where's this from?
That's from this one.
Wow.
So you want to close it now, actually. Put the lid on and shake it really good.
So we don't need this.
We will, but we want to shake it first.
Okay.
Yeah, so egg emulsions, I mean...
No chance.
Egg emulsions, you always want to shake before you use it. Though tempergrasse, more or less, doesn't really need shaking, but if you see any separation, you would shake it. The Flemish emulsion does separate, and you have to shake it really vigorously each time.
Each time you add color, will I stir it?
Well, each time you make tempera, paint.
Every time I make a little color, I keep ending up.
Yeah.
Do you use pigment? I use pigment.
Yeah, see, these are nice organic eggs. That's why it's so yellow.
Austrian eggs.
Yeah. All right, and this is...
Looks like mustard.
Looks delicious.
Is that 8.5 fluid ounces? Can you read that?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. So we want to add 2 drops of this secretive dryer for every 2 ounces. So I'm going to put 6 drops, because, well, I'm not going to put 6 drops because it's not full.
8, 4
yes,
times.
Mm.
2 drops every...
2 ounces.
So it's 4, yeah.
Yeah, you just ate it. Yeah, right. <That's> Okay. It's very strong stuff. And it seems weird, like, how can one drop do anything, you know?
Yeah.
I missed it. Okay. 1 or 2?
1.
2? I went 4, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
4. 3.
Four.
4 ounces.
1 drop per ounce.
Yes.
Now you can also... You can also not use the dryer. If your temper is dry, it's too fast for you. You wouldn't want to use the dryer. Then it'll slow it down a little bit. Some people even add a little linseed oil while they're painting.
Oh,
to slow it down even more. Depends, you know, how comfortable and how fast you usually paint it.
Does the paint medium also have a lizard on it or something to slow it down? Or still when you're making
Painting mediums are usually some kind of oil, a sand oil or a cold pressed linseed oil, and they can also have a varnish if it's a glazing kind of medium. Okay. Could also have turpentine, oil of spike lavender, which I like.
Oil of spike lavender?
Yeah, wow. It acts like linseed oil, but dries a little faster and everything smells really nice. But it's expensive. I mean, I was lucky because I found a bottle like that for 20 euros. Wow. Normally it'd be 200.
Wow.
It was like the last bottle of Burson. And they didn't know what it cost. I said, oh, that sells for 20.
Wow.
Okay.
Oh, wow.
All right, so now we're going to make tempera grossa. Does anyone have Kremnitz white paint?
I do.
Mm. You do?
Yeah.
So why don't you make yours? I mean,
you're going to make it out of not powder, but out of the paint?
No, we're going to use powder too.
Okay.
So Kremnitz white is the safest lead white paint. There's flake white, lead white, and Kremnitz. The old masters eventually just did their underpaintings in lead white.
And which one do you recommend?
I recommend Kremnitz, but if you can't afford it, because it's $50 for a tube of lead. 50 euros.
But you can make it go quite far because it spreads out.
Yeah, it'll last you for years anyway. Because you won't use it that much.
Yeah, I think okay. I bought this the last
time.
It's called
Oh, this is walnut oil. Interesting.
Who's
this from? Robinson? Hardy?
No.
Hurting?
Yeah.
Well, that's great.
Soft,
it doesn't yellow as much as linseed, but it's much slower dry. That's okay. It'll be speeded up another way. But do you want to also get titanium white? I didn't say anything.
Titanium.
And your container with sponge. Okay. So if we were painting in Flemish technique, just so for your side information. Then we would add water to the sponge. But in tempera grossa, we add turpentine. Okay, so I'm going to have to put a little turpentine. We need to have a bottle of turpentine. This is too awkward.
Oh, I think here is some of...
What?
Here is some
turpentine.
He's gone.
Does
anybody know how much 1 ounce is?
The premise.
No, just the measure in which 1 ounce is equivalent to...
The 60.
I'm not sure.
An egg is usually like 2 ounces.
I think it's 30 milliliter, but we can check it later. I'm not sure.
Okay. All right, so you want to take your sponge down. Right after clean up, whatever you did, okay? Okay, so now you want to put turpentine on your sponge.
Mm-hmm.
No, you're gonna. Yeah, this is the difficulty with these. So the best containers, I mean, it'll work okay. The best containers are gonna have a wider mouth, usually the same width of the bottle itself. Then it's easier to get your sponge in and out. That's all.
So I'm gonna stick it in there.
You want to soak it, or you can put it there and just drip over it. Yeah? So you want it absorbed well, but it doesn't need to be soaking wet and dripping. Yeah?
And is that turpentine?
It is.
Yes.
It's a good one, right?
Yeah, you want to use the good one. Always for anything that's going to go to the canvas or panel should be the best turpentine you can find. Yeah. For cleaning, you can use any scrumbly stuff.
Okay.
Alright, centiliter. Here's a nice, good, dry pigment. Can you pass the mirror?
The mirror?
Yeah. So you're going to use the mirror.
Secret writing.
All right, so you're going to shake that for a bit again, yeah? And then you're going to take a little of this, and people tend to take so much because they don't know it so much. But you don't need a lot. That's five paintings. Oh, it's about eight paintings.
Okay. It's about a teaspoon, right?
Yeah, well, I mean, if you're doing a big painting, then you need more. Right? whenever it's made fresh, it's the best.
Yeah.
I mean, it will last for a week or longer, 2 weeks. But if you make it fresh, it's even more potent. It adheres better. All right, you got your palette knife. You're gonna make a little volcano hole there.
Right in the center, good enough.
Mm-hmm. Oh, actually not yet. This is shaking good. Now you wanna chop that up to get any grains out. And I can tell she never did coke.
All my chemistry classes.
It's very revealing, this stage.
Right.
It's gonna grind it well. I never use this thing.
Is there any reason?
Folks never use it.
Is there any reason why you were doing that? You said it's chemistry. Is there any reason why you were
doing what?
Because it seemed like because when I made this before, uh-huh. It just seemed like it didn't stay separated. Like it was kind of smushing together, and not that that's bad, but it didn't feel intuitive to me. So it doesn't mean it means anything, but I just feel like this is sort of sticking to the bottom of the palate and feeling like it's getting kind of mushed into lumps instead
yeah,
of being.
But the mirror might have been already a little bit wet.
Yeah. So
you
way.
Ever use this for making pigments?
No, I've never used it.
Okay, so it's not.
I know how to do it, but yeah, I never used
it. But it's
it.
Not that necessary. stir them.
Okay, what do you think?
No, I mean, it's faster if you do that in some ways.
All right, now I do the volcano. Is that right?
Yeah, now you will do the whole, then shake your grasa one more time, and start to add a little bit at a time. Now to that we're going to add white oil paint.
Okay.
So a lot of people ask, well, why don't you just use oil paint? Well, the emulsion helps adhere. It's a binder. It helps adhere the paint.
Not very much, right? How much do you think?
Well, just enough to start. So that should look like oil paint in the end. So that's plenty to start.
Okay.
Maybe too much. We'll see.
Thinking perhaps. Then you have to add more white, right?
It also preserves the, white, and it also dries it. That's the chief ingredient thing. Dries the white quickly so you can keep underpainting.
Why do you have to add oil paint to it? Why couldn't you just use
it? You can use it like that.
Okay.
I also use it like just as it is. And if you, you know, if you add that to lighten up a color,
uh-huh.
you don't need any painting medium. Because it's also a painting medium.
Okay.
And it's supposed to get pretty dry, is that right?
So that
or is
really
it just creamy?
Half oil.
Oh, it's like oil paint, you said.
Is it hard?
No, it's very, it's like frosting.
Just the egg is the water content, you could
say.
Yeah,
I see. Yeah.
It's like an oil paint that's a little drier.
Not yeah, that's really. Probably good enough. Now, kind of gather it once it's blended enough.
Dry is actually good.
Yeah.
It's technically good.
It's
dry.
Okay, sorry about that squeaky sound, everyone. Okay.
Well, it reminds me of third grade.
Right.
All right, so then you're going to make, once you put that in the mound and can judge it by eye, you're going to want to use half kremnitz and half titanium. The same, so it equals, well, how much is there? And then you're going to put them all together.
So not equal parts of that, but half of this? Half that volume for this?
Would be titanium and the other half kremnitz.
Okay, so just try to estimate.
So don't go too close to it. If you get it wrong.
Okay, you right, but I cannot do it.
And Phil, why do you add the oil paint? What's the advantage of
that? Might be a little too much.
Then the tempera acts more like oil paint than tempera.
Okay.
Tempera is kind of stiff.
Yeah.
So the same, it has to be the same.
This makes it very painterly.
Okay. It should be this.
Okay.
This,
so
this plus
people that love
to
paint more loosely,
uh-huh.
expressionistically,
so how much
works good for them.
So the same
people
like
that
this?
Paint very
half.
Meticulous.
This should
it
be
can
half
work
and
good
then
for
the
them
other color.
Well.
Okay.
So it goes in all directions.
No,
or
half.
So where's the other?
And I like to do both
much,
myself. So that's why I was searching for that.
Where's the other color?
Huh?
Where's the other color? When I'm doing, you said
your kremnitz?
I used this color. Oh, there it is.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Now, again, kremnitz white is lead white, which is probably the most poisonous stuff to use. But the kremnitz is a safe lead, you could say. It's made in a way that the poison toxins in it is quite filtered out. Flake white, on the other hand, is very pure lead white. I've used that too. That's what all the old masters use.
You can't buy it anymore.
Okay.
Yeah, I have a nice thing in there.
Okay.
You can buy it from, I think Thomas Harding makes it now.
Okay.
And it's like, what, $180? What did you pay for yours?
I don't remember. Because I can't remember what series it was.
Yeah, it's probably $70, $80.
Well, mine wasn't $70 or
$80. No? Less?
Yes, because I didn't get the violet color because that was like $45. I can't read what series.
Kremnitz is like Old Holland would be €50.
Yeah, it's not that much.
So you don't necessarily
it's
need
like
20 it. Yeah?
20.
That's a really good deal. Really?
They're on a sale. Okay.
All right, so then those whites both go into the tempera. And again, yeah, you could just use the tempera grassa. A lot of grassa painters, that's all they do, is make the grassa and then dilute that with turpentine. I like doing it this way because it's even more pliable, more painterly.
Mm-hmm. Can you get a little bit of sort of impasto effect with that knot?
Yeah, you could. It'd be safer to do it with an emulsion than just oil. It's less likely to crack.
Okay.
All right, so then you're going to try and get a nice mound of it together, pile, so that it goes on your sponge as a pile, rather than spreading it on, then they lose paint into the sponge.
Do you wet the sponge before you
paint? Yeah, it's got turpentine on it. And try not to press the paint into the sponge, because then you're going to lose a lot of it. Okay. So it's just sit on there. And the turp and fumes will keep it wet and fresh. When you're not using it, be sure to put your tap on your bottle.
So it's creating the sponge that's like creating microclimate.
Yeah, that's right.
Oh, that's creating.
Yeah, I like that term. Yeah.
Creating a what?
Microclimate.
Oh, wow.
Oh.
For the paint, yeah.
Beautiful.
Yeah, and if we made Flemish tempera, then the sponge would be water. And the emulsion wouldn't have any oils in it, other than the yolk and varnish.
Okay. But I've never made a tempera that thick, ever.
You've never what?
I've never made a tempera that thick.
So yeah, you just dilute it with turpentine. That's why it lasts so long, because it's nice and concentrated. Yeah, you gotta be careful how you get it in there. So that's why, again, containers with same size lids, It's just easier to deal with, to get the sponge in and out.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
My lid is.
All right, so you're all gonna do this.
Okay.
And then you'll be ready to underpaint first thing in the morning. Yeah? Nice. And we're gonna have two slideshows as well. One will be like a survey through history of niche technique painters and some variations to it. Mm-hmm. And the other is tempered grass underpainting and glazing.